In this illustration, we'll analyze another capacitive circuit where this figure shows two batteries connected to two capacitors in a single loop. And we are required to find the steady state charge on capacitors and potential difference across the points M and N. So we solve it again by distribution of potentials, for which we can take on the right side of battery of 40 volts, say the potential is 0 at point O. Then at point M, potential will be taken as 40. If on the other side of this battery, potential is taken as X, on this side, potential will be taken as X plus 20. Now, for this potential X, we can write the equation. If we write equation for X, there are two capacitor plates connected with the terminal of potential X. So we can write down its equation as the charges on these two plates to be zero. So charge on this will be 5x plus charge on this plate will be 3 multiplied by x plus 20 minus 40, which should be equal to 0. On simplifying, this will give us 5x plus 3x, 8x is equals to, this is 60. So the value of x will be 7.5 volt. And if we got the value of X, we can get the charges on both of these capacitors. As they are connected to one another by one wire through battery, the charges on the two capacitors must be equal, as these can also be considered in series. So here we can write charge on 3 microfarad is equals to charge on 5 microfarad, which is equal to, directly you can write it as 5X, this 5 multiplied by 7.5. That is 37.5 microcoulomb. That will be one answer. The charge, steady state charges on capacitors. If we wish to find out the potential difference Vm minus Vn, so here Vm we can directly write as 40 volt, and Vn we have already calculated as X, which is 7.5 volt. So from here we can calculate Vm minus Vn. That is 40 minus 7.5, that is 32.5 volt. That will be another answer for this problem.